दिस राइट हेयर इज आवर वॉट PNL account and here looks like it is formatted. Now rank is something that I have personally incorporated while I audit and analyze the financial statements. Okay, so this is something totally on your own that you want to do it or not. And how do I give ranks? I give ranks on the basis of the importance, that is, suppose I look beyond materiality, that is, if there is an expense that is a fire expense that needs to be looked on, hence I give it a rank before the okay. So basically I take qualitative concepts also in mind before giving ranks, and rank is essential for the clients that I have because they are big clients and their time is important. So suppose now if there is an increase, what's the increase amount here? 10%. Okay, I'll just suppose if I give it rank 1, hence a time of a client is important, hence as you can understand the client cannot invest to save rupees 500 and then lose the opportunity cost of his time which he could have used otherwise, and he could have earned more than 500. Okay, so basically you got the system of ranks, but it's totally on you if you want to do it or not. Okay, so we are good to go, and let's calculate the vertical analysis for each and every year. That is, let's start with the previous year first, hide them so that there is no confusion. Now how much amount of net sales is okay, just a second. So the question goes to you, what should be the base that we should take? Like here we took the base total asset, we took the base total liabilities, we took the base total stockholders equity. Oops, something wrong. Yeah, something wrong. Yeah, but that is only a clerical error again because we are not truly analyzing it. That is, this should have been divided by this amount right here. Okay, and this should not be here. Okay, hence there is a 46% increase, there is a 55% difference. So these are the areas that should be considered more. Okay, let's leave this and tell me what should be the base of the base. That is, like here was total asset, that is it. What should be the figure that we should divide it everything to? Well, I say it should be net sales. Okay, and let's believe me blindly first, then I'll explain you the concept. Divide by this only, of course, F4, and enter, click on percentage right here. Okay, it might be unclear to you because I did it very fast. So this divide by, okay, let's leave it. Okay, now how much amount of cost of goods sold, how much amount of sales is cost of goods sold? Okay, how much amount of sales is cost of goods sold? How much percentage of sales is cost of goods sold? Equal to this divide by this into 100. Okay, 50%. Okay, accepted. Now if you want, you can apply that percentage so it looks classy. Yeah, okay, let's start copying, and I'll use this divide by this because that's what happened right here, right? That is, stockholders equity was divided by itself. Yeah, I know what's the issue. Oops, something went wrong. Okay, this should not be the case. Let's correct this first because I am like that movie accountant. I can't leave my work unfinished. Unhide. Where are you, bro? Unhide. What now? Unhide, yes. Okay, so this was this divided by this F4. Okay. And this was this divided by this F4, enter. Okay, so this one is the correct value, and yeah, good to go. Welcome back to PNL. As the my point was, this was divided by itself, hence sales will be obviously divided by itself, because that is what in the that is what the amount is in the denominator is. Now let's change, that is how much amount of expenses, how much percentage of expenses does, how much percentage of sales does expenses contributes. Okay, so as everything is happening for sales, suppose, okay, and we have depreciation here, so we'll allocate this amount to sales and think that if it's worthy or not. If it's not worthy, then we'll sell that asset. Okay, that is why we calculate this vertical analysis. You will learn more now, just hold on. Okay, oops, what happened now, ma'am? So equal to this divided by this percentage. Yeah, now let's do it quickly, because F4, why did I not enter F4? And where is my percentage sign? Copying it further, enter. Okay, now what do you need to total to get to 100%? So I think this should be 50% should be added in this, and then this. Okay, so yeah, good to go. And why is this not added? Because this is the total of, yeah, because this is basically this minus this. Okay, so either you can do this or you can just, yeah, basically just let it be. I'll explain you right now that what I wanted to tell you, that why do we always keep net sales and denominator, that is everything, every expense is happening for sale only, and that is salary, rent, etc. Okay, so let's get to know how much expenses is incurred to get this percentage of sales. So 3% expenses are incurred to get 100% of sales, looks very legit. Now, are there any high expenses? That is 50% of cost of goods sold. You can go further and audit it. Okay, let's enter the other one so that we can compare. Unhide, where are you? Let me hide this. Hide this. Okay, calculating those formula, this divide by self only, F4. Okay, okay, I'll let it be everywhere. Unhide, and then difference. Okay, then let it be rank. So current minus previous 20, enter, copying it to every field. Okay, what are the fields that we need to look into now? That is 2% of operating income has increased from the total amount of sales. Okay, So that is pretty much acceptable. Why is there a 1% difference? Okay, interesting. General. What just really happened? Okay. Yeah, this is okay. And this should be zero. Some Excel thing. Let it be. You can never solve the mystery of Excel. Don't worry about it. So yeah, you can see that 30% of total sales is net income, okay, in the previous year. Now this is an acceptable difference, okay. And in this year there is a 29% of net income in the total sales. Now 1% might look okay, but as you see 1% here, it is difference of 5,000, okay. And this is a company that is very small company. Now what if Facebook has a difference of 1%? It will be like $44 billion or something. Okay, so that is how you analyze the vertical balance sheets and vertical P&L. That is the total. We'll set total asset as the base amount and the percentage. Okay, they would be exceeding expectations. Okay, now let's try to do it in Tally, and Tally has an automatic feature which will do it automatically, so there will be no longer processes. Hence, see you in the next lecture. Good day.
I care.